Hello friends, today I am discussing about the tablet chapter. Tablet is very important part of the solid dosage form. So there are different type of methods are very important and used also for the making of tablet. Just like example, wet or moist granulation method and dry granulation method and direct compression method, etc. So today I am discussing the different type of important questions from tablet chapter. Okay. So first of all, what do you mean tablet? Tablet is a solid dosage form. There are different type of shape and sizes available. And excipients part and inactive ingredients means excipients, and active ingredients means medicaments, just like a drug is used to make the tablet. So what are the types of tablet? Compressed tablet, sugar coated tablet, film coated tablet, effervescent tablet, enteric coated tablet, chewable tablet, buccal and sublingual tablet. What are the multiple compressed tablet? Actually tablet is prepared by the compression machine. So single punch, double punch, multiple compression machine, different type of punch are available. So here multiple compression tablet means it is made by the more than one compression cycle, and they are usually prepared to separate physically or chemically incompatible ingredients or to produce the repeat or prolonged active of the drug. That means in this case the advantages is the prolonged effect of the drug. Okay, and then what is the difference between tablet and pills? Actually tablets are made from the granulated and powder ingredients that are tightly pressed together during manufacturing to make a hard pill. But tablet pills may then have more additives and non-active ingredients than liquid capsule. Okay, and are capsules faster than tablet? Obviously capsule faster than tablet, because the absorption power of the capsule is high, and the one part of gelatin is it is used to make the capsule. So the outer surface of the capsule is one type of shell, and this shell is made by the capsule, and it has a quick faster action and absorption power it has more than tablets. And another question is, why are tablets made instead of capsule? The same answer. And why are the tablets more expensive than capsule? Actually in this case tablet is more expensive, because this expensive part depends on the excipients and the methods or manufacturing process of the tablet or capsule. Can I open the pills and take it? Actually without any permission of any medical practitioner, I think the capsule should not open. Okay, because should not open, break or don't chew, crush, etc. Okay, and when you will prepare the capsule, then you will one type of give a design. So main active ingredients, that means pure drug, will be encapsulated, okay, through the design. So that's why without any permission or any advice, I think don't chew, don't break, crush or open the capsule. Another question is, can you open capsule and take the powder? You should same question, same answer. And are gel capsules better than tablet? It is also same answer. I am already discussing about this matter. Capsule is far better than the tablets, and because it has the absorption power is more. What happens to the plastic in capsule? Actually plastic means here hard gelatin capsule and soft gelatin. When the capsule is prepared, then the outer surface is called a cell, and then one gelatin is used to prepare this cell part, and after administration it is absorbed. What the advantages of the capsule over a tablet? Capsule tend to break down more quickly than the tablets. And another question is, are capsules better than powder? Obviously. How long does it take for a pill to reach your stomach? 15 to 30 minutes. How long does it take for a pill to work? A dose of medication will reach a peak, a maximum level in the blood 30 minutes to 4 to 6 hours after it is taken, and the peak time varies for different things. Why are pills coated with plastic? Actually, it is used to protect the doses from the stomach acid, that means hydrochloric acid. What is the principle of the tablet compression? In this case, the hydraulic pressure should be used. And what is the hydraulic pressure? The pressure is transmitted unreduced through the static field. Any externally applied pressure is transmitted via static field to all the direction in the sum proportion. What is the compaction force in compression machine? Because of difference between applied force at upper punch, which affects material close to lower punch, is called a compaction machine. That means compaction machine is included to the compression, compaction force is included to the compression machine. Compaction force means in the compression machine, the upper punch and lower punch both are attached. So when you apply the force on the upper punch, then automatically the materials will be close to the lower punch, and then due to this force, the tablet should be made as a different type of shape and size. Why the tablet coating? The coating is actually very important part for the tablet. It helps to protect tablet from stomach. That means hydrochloric acid is all time secreted from the stomach, so it protects the tablet from the acid, and it is also used for the sustained release pattern of the drug. Okay. What is the difference between compression and compaction? I have already told. What is the difference between API and excipient? API means active pharmaceutical ingredients, that means the pure drug. And excipients means there are different type of excipients, just like a binding agent, lubricating agent, absorbing agent, coloring agent, preservative, diluent, glidant, etc. And when the active pharmaceutical ingredients are mixed with the excipient parts, then the granulation should be formed, and after granulation it should be used in the compression machine for making of tablet. Define the tablet, I have told already. So tablet is very important part. Another question is the different term of excipients. So I am just now I have explained the what is the excipient and what is the function of excipient. Are excipients harmful? No, this is very much helpful. What is the role of the excipient? Same question. Okay. And what is the difference between active pharmaceutical ingredients and excipients? Already I have told. What are the tablet excipients? I have told. And name the different types of excipients is important. Which type of excipients are diluent, granulating agent, binding agent, disintegrating agent, lubricant, adjuvants and coloring agent. So after some times I will explain elaborately about this excipients part. So what are the pharmaceutical additives or excipients? Everyone knows that. What are the additives and components of the tablet? Additives means the excipients. Why diluent is needed in certain tablet formulation? Actually, diluent is one type of excipient part, and it is used to improve the cohesion, enhance flow and adjust weight of the tablet as per dietary. And the diluent is needed in the formulation of a tablet when the quantity of the medicament in each tablet is very small and it is not possible to make a good tablet. That's why diluent is used. And give a list of granulating agent. It is used for the making of granulation. Why is a binding agent required in certain type of tablet? Actually, binding agent is a very important excipient part. And when you will prepare the granulation, then binding agent should be mixed properly, because it is to bring cohesion to the mix of powders and thus produce the tablets with acceptable hardness and friability. How disintegrating agent helpful in the disintegration time? Actually, disintegrating agent is a help for the proper disintegration of tablet. It comes into contact with a fluid, and the agent can be added before or after weight granulation stage. If the disintegrating agent is added after formulation, that is called extragranular phase. Next, disintegrating agent, these are added into the formulation of our oral tablets or sublingual tablets. In the medicament is insoluble in water, a disintegrating agent is needed. Disintegrating agents act in three ways: by swelling, by producing effervescence, and the melt at body temperature, example cocoa butter. The disintegrating agent is divided into two parts. One part mixed along with other excipients before the formation of granules, and another part mixed with the dry granulation before compression. Fire lubricants is very important as a excipient in compressed. Lubricant prevent ingredients from the clumping together and sticking to the tablet punch. Actually, lubricating agent is used to reject easily. It is used from the easily ejection from the punch. Actually, it prevent the stickiness after punching, after compression, when the tablet, when you collect the tablet from the punching machine, then lubricating agent helps to prevent the stickiness between the tablet and the die cavity or punching machine. Upper punch and lower punch also lubricants, glidants, anti-adhesive agents. Okay, actually lubricants are divided into three groups: lubricants, glidants, anti-adhesive agent. Which lubricant is not used in oral tablets? Stearic acid. What is an example of an effervescent tablet? Example, calcium carbonate tablet. What is the effervescence? Give example. Effervescence is the formation of the gas bubbles in a liquid by a chemical reaction. When the gas bubbles is formed into the liquid by the chemical reaction, that is called effervescence. An example, effervescence is the release of carbon dioxide which bubbles as a gas from liquid. That means when the gas bubbles is formed into the liquid by the chemical reaction. So example is the carbon dioxide. It is a one type of gas, and it is produced into the liquid from the liquid by the chemical reaction. When limestone chips which are composed of calcium carbonate are added to dilute acid. What is the formula of the effervescence? The tablet produces effervescence through a chemical reaction. The tablet with its chemical formula and CO3 is also known as baking soda or sodium bicarbonate. How does temperature affect effervescence? Loss of carbonations. Okay, and why no effervescent tablet dissolve faster in hot water? Actually, in the hot water, the tablet should have more vigorously produced bubbles than in the cold water. The higher the temperature, the faster the molecules move. So that's why it dissolves faster in hot water. Globules, more globules should be formed. Why do tablets dissolve faster in hot water? Same answer. This question is very important. The defect. What are the manufacturing defects of tablet? Capping. Capping defect means when the partial or complete removal of the top or bottom portion of the tablet, and it caused by the different type of reason: defective punches and die, high speed of the tablet machine. There is an usually high degree of compression. Next, picking and sticking. Picking materials removed or picked up by the upper punch from the upper surface of the tablet, and it is caused by the use of the own out dies and punches, use of small quantity of lubricants, presence of moisture in the granules, excess of powder in the granules, mottling. Mottling means an unequal distribution of color. This means color defects. When the undistribution of the color on the surface of the tablet is shown, that means this is the mottling problem. Another problem is weight variation. During the compression of granules in a weight machines, the tablets don't have a uniform weight. Granules are not uniform in size. Presence of excess amount of powder in the granules, number proper mixing of the lubricants, number uniform flow of granules from the hopper to the die. Next, hardness variation. Hardness variation is a problem, and it depends on the weight of the materials and the space between the upper and lower punches during the stage of compression. Next, double impression. This defect occurs when the lower punch has a monogram or some other and during the compression the tablet because on the imprint of the punch due to some effect of the machine, the lower punch moves slightly upward before the ejection of the tablet and gives a second. Mean the materials is film coating tablet, hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose HPMC carboax, enteric coating tablet. Which type of materials are used? Cellulose acetate phthalate, polyvinyl acetate phthalate. Define the term microencapsulation. It is a process by which individual particles of an active agent can be stored within a cell surrounded or coated with a continuous film of polymeric materials to produce particles in the micrometer to millimeter range for protection and or later relief. Microencapsulation is a process by which solid, liquids or even gases may be enclosed in microscopic particles by formation of thin coating of wall material around the substance. Briefly describe the microencapsulation. Briefly describe the microencapsulation technique. Pan coating, fluidized bed coating and coconversion. This type of methods are very important. Electrostatic deposition, vacuum deposition, polymerization, multi-orifice centrifugal. Application of microencapsulation. It is used for masking the taste of bitter drugs and it is used for preparing prolonged action dosage form. It is used for the modifying the physical characters of a material required in certain formulations. And the technique is used to separate an incompatible material. It is used to protect the chemicals against moisture and oxidation. Next, classification. Tablets ingest orally. Compressed tablet, multiple compressed tablet, multi-layer tablets, first injection, enteric coated, sugar coated, film coated, chewable tablet, tablet used in the oral cavity, buccal, sublingual, lozenge tablet, dentacones. Tablet administered by other routes in implantation tablet, anal tablet used to prepare solution, effervescent dispensing, hypodermic tablet triturates. This is the type of tablets. Give the advantages of the film coating tablet. It is less time consuming technique, not much labor required. Coating is the resistant to cracking and chipping. No waterproof coating is required before actual film coating the tablet become elegant. Coating is resistant to cracking and chipping. It protects the drug from the atmospheric changes such as light, air and moisture. Why are tablets coated with film? Sugar or film coating surrounds the tablet to make it and taste better. The coating is designed to hold the tablet together in the stomach. Maybe there is a protect the stomach from the stomach. Right, the advantages of tablet coating, same answer. Why coating is required? It is also same answer. And what are the type of coating? Film coating, enteric coating, sugar coating, etc. What are the basic components of the coating? Two components, the vehicle and the pigments. Advantages. What are the advantages and disadvantages of the tablets? So first of all, advantages. They are economical dosage form. They are more tamper proof in compared to capsule, bitter and nauseous substance can be given easily in the tablet packaging, and transport is more cheapest. The tests are easy to be administered and dispensed. What is the disadvantages? Poor bioavailability or poor soluble drugs or poorly absorbable drugs. Some drugs resist compression into tablet, difficulty in swallowing. Some patients, pediatric and geriatrics, inability to use the unconscious and during the vomiting. Next, the name the various type of machines used for the compression: single punch, multi punch, total tablet, dry quota tablet machine. Briefly describe the enteric coated tablet. Enteric coated tablet is related to the intestine. And medicaments got decomposed or destroyed by the acidic medium for the stomach. Drug absorption is better in the intestines. Delayed action is needed. An ideal enteric coating materials had some property: resistance to enteric fluids, non-toxic in the required quantity, economical, easy of applications without specialized equipment. The film of the coating materials should not change readily susceptibility to intestinal fluid. What are the enteric coating tablet used from? Enteric coating is a useful strategy for the oral cavity of the drugs like insulin. Where does enteric coated tablet dissolve? It doesn't dissolve stomach, intestine. What is the difference between enteric coated and film coated tablet? Depending on the polymers used in it. That means the difference depends on the polymer. Is there a difference between coated and enteric coated aspirin? Enteric coated aspirin is designed to resist dissolving and being absorbed in the stomach. As such, enteric coated aspirin passes into the small intestine, where it's absorbed into the bloodstream. Which is the better, coated and uncoated? Uncoated aspirin based for the heart protection. And can you take enteric coated aspirin and empty stomach? No, you may take with food or meal. Don't crush and don't chew enteric coated tablets. What is the limit of the friability of the tablet? USP limit 100 rotation. What is the disintegration time of the coated tablet? At 15 to 25 degrees centigrade, it dissolves in water within 3 minutes. What is the benefit of the enteric coated tablet? Enteric coated aspirin is designed to resist dissolving and being absorbed in the stomach. How long doesn't it take for enteric coated aspirin to work? 3 to 4 hours. How do you calculate friability test? W1 minus W2 into 100 divided by W1. Okay. What is the difference between coated and uncoated tablet? Tablets can be either coated with a sugar or film coating, or uncoated tablets are rubber, may be more difficult to swallow and often leave weird taste in the mouth. Why enteric coating is done? Enteric coating is a useful strategy for the oral delivery of a drug. What is the difference between dispersible aspirin and enteric coated aspirin? In the dispersible form, the aspirin is rapidly absorbed in the stomach, whereas the enteric coated form is absorbed in the duodenum. What are the side effects of taking daily aspirin? Stroke caused by the burst blood vessel. While daily aspirin can help prevent a clot related stroke. Why is the powder drug not compressed as such into the tablet form? Fine powder doesn't flow evenly through the hopper of the tablet machine. The irregular supply of the fine powder into the dye of the tablet machine powders tablet of different weight. In case of powder containing different ingredients, the vibration. Why is coating of tablet done? To mask the unpleasant task and order to improve the appearance of tablet, to prevent the medicament from atmospheric effect, to control the site of action of drug, to produce the sustained release product. What is the granulating agent it is used for? The better granulation. What is the granulating fluid? Same. What is the granulation method? It is also same. Which granulation method is the best? Among these two techniques, wet granulation method, moist and dry granulation method. What is the difference between wet and dry granulation method? Dry granulation and wet granulation are two of them, and the main difference is that dry granulation is the process of forming granules without using any liquid solution, whereas wet granulation is the process of forming granulation by adding the granulating fluid. Why granulation is required? Granulation is carried out for the various reasons, one of which is to prevent the segregation of the constituents of powder mix. Segregation is due to difference in the size of the density of the component of the mix. Powder, sugar and small particles have poor flow and compression characteristic. Wet and moist granulation method. This is the wet and moist granulation method. This is the most widely used method of preparing granules. The powder medicaments with other excipients such as the aline binding agent and part of disintegration, this type of excipients are used. Procedure of wet granulation method. There are different type of step 1, step 2, step 3. Step 1, wing and blending. Step 2, wet granulate prepare by adding the blender solution. Step 3, screening the damp mass into the pellets of granules 6 to 8 mesh. Step 4, drying the granulation in thermostatically controlled oven. Step 5, dry staining. Step 6, mixing with other ingredients, a fairy lubricant, a dry lubricant, anti-adherent and gradient is added to the granulation granules either by dusting over the spread out granules or blending with the granules. Step 7, tableting. The step in which the tablet is fed into the dry cavity and then compressed. This is the flowchart of the wet and moist granulation method. Everyone please follow this flowchart. This is very much important.